Hello there. Theresa May used a velvet glove to hold out an olive branch to the EU. But was there an iron fist inside that velvet glove? In her Florence speech today, the UK Prime Minister Theresa May set out her vision of a future of joint prosperity for the UK and the EU. She said that it was profoundly beholden on both the UK and the EU to work constructively and creatively to forge a brand new relationship between the two, a relationship better than other states may be enjoyed. Now, although she stated unequivocally several times in her speech and in questions afterwards that the UK will leave the European Union on Brexit Day in March 2019, she also offered a transition period of up to 2 years after that to bed the relationship in, a period in which freedom of movement will still continue, albeit with a registration process. It was also unclear as to who would be in charge in the UK during that period, us or the ECJ. She also said that the UK would make sure that the EU was not out of pocket during the current budget period and will also continue to pay its way with any joint enterprises that the UK and EU decided to work on after we leave. Now, all that many people will have got from her speech is that the UK is tied to the EU for another 2 years. And many businesses will be heaving a short-term sigh of relief thinking, back to business as usual, we'll address Brexit nearer the deadline, because they think the deadline will keep being pushed out into the future. Committed Brexiteers will also be feeling let down, while Remainers will be very happy to see an extension to their plotting timetables. But remember, this is not a done deal. This is yet to be even considered by the EU. So now consider that the UK Prime Minister has made an offer to the EU. This is an offer based on mutual economic advantage and therefore one the EU cannot politically accept under any circumstances. As the former head of the Bank of England, Lord King, said yesterday, the EU is a political construct that will not be affected by financial concerns. If the EU works constructively and creatively with the UK, and it works, how many other countries will then want to follow in our footsteps? The EU is committed to punishing the UK for leaving the fold, even with the knowledge that it will cause damage to itself in the process. I don't think that Theresa May made the offer to the EU. I suspect she knows that that would fail. I think she knew before she laid one finger on the keyboard to start typing her speech that any offer by the UK of anything other than total capitulation to their demands will be dismissed out of hand by the Eurocrats. So I think she is making the offer to the individual citizens, businesses and member state governments of the EU, whilst making sure that the wider world is watching. The message is, work with us for our mutual success. Maybe then the pressure from those quarters will force the EU elite to sit down and talk trade. But I won't hold my breath. I think the political need for the EU upper echelons to work towards ever closer union will prevent a positive response from them. But that won't endear them to their serfs who rely on a good EU-UK relationship to put food on the table. And of course, behind all of this is the unspoken risk that the UK could just walk away, potentially causing damage to the top EU economies. And both sides understand that. And that could be the iron fist inside the velvet glove holding today's olive branch. The offer has been made, and if the EU is seen not to respond positively, then the UK can be justified in walking away from the table at any time. Thankfully, the Prime Minister also restated that no deal was better than a bad deal. Now, what do you think of Theresa May's offer? Please leave a comment below. Thank you. Please do like and share this video. And also subscribe to my channel. And when subscribing, please do remember to press on the little bell next to the subscribe button. That way you'll get an alert every single time I put up a new video. Thank you very much for watching.